Hello friends, so today in this video we can discuss a problem from LeetCode, problem name sum of mutated array closest to target. So I have like this is a problem from biweekly contest 16 and I just thought to make a video on that. So let's understand the problem statement first. It is stating that you're given an integer array arr and you're also given a target value. Now you have to return an integer value such that when you change all the integers larger than value, so you have to just return a value such that if you change all the values in the integer which are larger than value to the given like to the value which is given to you, so you have to output some value. I will also make you understand with the example part. So you have to just return out the sum of the array which is as close to the target as possible. So as you can see, and if there's a tie, return out the minimum integer. So we'll understand it more with the example. As you can see, the array which is given to me is 493. Now, if you choose some integer, let's assume 3. If you choose 3, then what you'll do, you'll iterate over the array from left to right, or like you just find out that if there exists a number which is larger than 3, then you'll make it equal to 3. So you have to output any integer, you have to output an integer such that if you take that integer and if you do a minimum of that integer with all the values in the array, then you have to replace that number with the minimum value, minimum of the current integer and the value which you have outputted, and then you have to add all the numbers in the array, and then that number should be as close as to the target. Now how it is, so as you can see, the given input array has some sum. Okay, now if you take that sum, then that must be somewhat close to the target. But now if you choose some another number which is smaller, then you can decrease or increase the array sum. Okay, you cannot increase it more than this because, okay, but you can decrease it officially. Like if you can decrease it, you can decrease it closest to target value. Now you just have to tell that whether, also as you can see, it in absolute difference, the sum of the array an absolute difference. So as you can see, if I choose some smaller number, let's assume if I choose some very small number, let's assume -1000, okay, then I will take out -1000, the difference between that number and the other number. Are you getting the point? So I cannot take negative numbers, but still the number which I can take, the difference between that number and the current number, is the value. So I want to make my target value as close to the possible. Okay, I have to just replace these numbers, and then a difference between the target value and my total sum should be as close as possible. The difference, the absolute difference, should be as close as possible. Okay, so now what you can understand from the logic part, like, so as you can see, there are some numbers and then there is sum for that. Okay, so let's assume that the sum is s1, so I can just delete out, the sum is s1 of all the numbers. Okay, now there is one target value. Okay, if you somehow, as you can see, you can, if you take some number and if you take the minimum of the current number with all of the numbers, then what can happen, the thing what can happen is, like, you can decrease the number obviously, but you can also increase this number. Okay, the maximum number is equal to the total sum of this, because you cannot go more than that. Okay, why? Because you can only decrease this number. Okay, because you only have to find out the minimum of the current number and the target. So if the target is also very large, still the minimum is the number itself, so you can only decrease it. So let's assume that the total sum is capital S and the smaller sum can be, you can make everything zero. Now if you find out the difference between this target value and this, let's assume that this sum, then if you somehow keep on decreasing this sum, it will get closest to the target, and then it can get closest to target, and then it will keep on increasing. So it's like a hill. I hope you get the point. So I will tell you with more examples. So let's assume that if you take out some number which is, so if the array is, let's assume this only, which is 493. Okay, if I take one means that if I take the value for equal to 1, so the minimum number can get 111, which is equal to 3. If I take a 2, if I take the number value 2, such that if I find out the minimum of that number and the 2 itself, so it will become 2 to 2, so it will increase, so it will become 6. So as you can see, it keep on increasing. Okay, but as you can see, it keep on increasing. Obviously if I take 4, then it will keep on increasing till the capital S, which is the sum of this. But I am not finding out this value. I'm finding out the absolute difference between this and a target value. So let's assume the target value is equal to, let's assume the target value equal to 5. So now I'm actually finding out a difference between the total sum and this 5 value. So the difference between them is equal to initially 2. Now, then it will become 1. Then in keep on increasing, let's assume it will become 5. So as you can see, first it is increasing up to some point, and then like, so it is like somewhat decreasing, and then it keep on increasing. So it's like a dip at this point. Okay, so because that's the closest point at which I can get. So in such a problem, it's beneficial to use binary search, because it's like, I'm going down to the bottom part, to the most closest part. And that's what we're gonna do. We'll use binary search to find out the closest target value. It is also like a similar problem in which we have to find out what if the array is given to you and it is rotated about a pivot point, and you have to find out what is the pivot in log n time. So it is also like a finding the pivot point in log n using binary search in some sort of like this only, in which there is some sort of value like this. So if you have some tree or like a hill or a valley, then you can also use a binary search, because it will eventually help you to get down to the like minimum value. Okay, so now what we'll do in binary search, if you understand the binary search playlist, I can go you through the code and then it will make you more clear. So there are two values, left and right, for the binary search, obviously. So the left part is 0, or like you can also mark it as 1, like which is the minimum smallest value you can take, and the maximum value. Maximum value is the maximum value is equal to the maximum element in this value, in this whole array. Why I'm taking this? See, in lot of binary search problem, I actually take this R as the global maximum. The global maximum can be 10 to the power 5, because the value can go up 10 to the power 5 only. Okay, but the thing is, see, in this value, if I take out, let's assume the value which is equal to, if I find out this value, maybe the value is equal to 10. If I print out 10 and also 11 and also 12, all will give the same answer. Why? Because even if I keep on increasing the number, if I take that as a value, then the array value will be giving the same answer, because like, as you can see, I have to find out the difference, like the minimum of the current value and the value itself. And if the small number is smaller, then even if we keep on increasing the number, this number will not change. And thus, finding out a very large number, even though that's the answer, but we have to find out, in case of tie, find out the minimum integer. And the minimum integer will always be in the range only. So that's why I have to find out the maximum number in this integer range. And the minimum is 0, 1. Like I can take, you can take 1 also, because the minimum can be 1. Then you have to find out, because in this sort of thing, you have to find out, it is like a value. So in this, you have two options. Either like you can go down like this or like this. Okay. So you have two ways, like the left minimum and the right minimum. The left minimum and the right minimum. So you have to take the both of them. So the left minimum difference, so as you can see, you have to find out the absolute difference now. So absolute difference can be, so the absolute difference is the absolute difference between the sum and the target. Okay, so as you can see, this value, absolute difference, can be equal to like minus x or plus x. It means that it can be on the left side of this value or the right side. Okay, so that's what we're gonna have to take. Yeah, and it can be as maximum as possible. So I just initialize it int max, and this is the left best and the right best. Okay, then this is the while loop. Then what we'll do, we have two options. Then we'll find out a middle value, and middle value means that, okay, if I take this number as the middle value, as the value which you want to print out, then we have to first get the total sum, and the total sum initializing with this mid value is, I just write down this function, iterate over the total array, and just find out the total of the minimum of the current I and the mid value, and just return out that. So it just print out the new array in terms of this mid value. Okay, now I have two options, whether this sum is less than target or greater than target. If it is less than target, it means it is on the left side. If it is on the left side, I have two options, whether this is closest to the target, like the absolute difference between this sum and the target is smaller than the left difference, then we'll change it, because this is the left difference, because this is on the left side, so this is the left difference, and if it on the right side, then it is the right difference. So as you can see, I just find out the absolute difference between the target and the sum. If it is smaller than the left difference, then what we'll do, we'll update the left difference with this value, and the left best is this mid value. okay, and then because we're on the left side, what we'll do, to go to the more, so as you can see, if you're on this path, if you want to go down the hill, we'll make my left increment by 1. So left will like left will be mid plus 1, okay, and else if you're on the right side, then if you want, because you want to go down in the hill, so it's like a number value. So as you can see, this is like a 3, then 2, then 1, and then it is again like increasing, which is like 5 and 6 and 8. Okay, so if you're on this point and we want to go to this index, this is like 0th index, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. If you're on this index and you want to go down the hill, we have to make my I plus 1. But if you're on this point, I want to go down the hill. If you're on the right side, then we have to go down, like down the, to this point, we have to make my I subtract power. Okay, and we'll do the same thing. If you're on the right side, then if the right side difference is smaller than the value which you are looking for, then update that value and this is the right best. Okay, then in the end, we just have our values, which is the left best and the right best. Okay, then what we'll do, we'll just check that if my left difference is less than the right difference. So I have two options now, the left difference and the right difference. If the left difference is smaller, then we'll put the left best. So I have left best, what is the best value which will give my answer in the left side and the right side. But I have to only print that which is having the smallest difference. Okay, so I have two differences on the left side and the right side. Difference between the target and the total sum on the left side and the right side. And whichever is having the lower difference, I will print that value, the value according to that. I hope you understand the logic and code part for this problem. If you still have any doubts, you can mention down. Ask the rest until then. Keep coding and bye.